Lara, thank you very much for your kind introduction. Now, hello, everyone. This is Makoto Takahashi from KDDI. So it's my great honor to join this session. I'd like to talk about an AI and the real and the KDDI's journey and the related beyond connectivity. At first, I think you may not know so much about KDDI. So let me briefly introduce. KDDI is the second largest operator in Japan, and having 31 million mobile subscribers. Around the world, we operate 45 data center sites by its brand name, Telehouse. And we have 50 million IoT connections, mainly from big, almost casing the Toyota Motor Company. So, the left chart is from a GSMA document around 2016. So, vertical line shows the telecom network. And the horizontal line shows the customer touch points. It was quoted to say that operators having strengths on both network and the customer touch points would be successful as a life platformer. And KDDI has been aiming to be a life platformer by focusing on not only telecom services, but value-added ones. Please take a look at the figure for 2023 and compare it to 2015. So it has more than doubled, and value-added services have grown to account for 44% of the revenue. And this is KDDI's vision and purpose, and as we look forward to 2030. So enhancing the power to connect, and we improve people's life and the day-to-day lives and hearts and minds. And we empower people's dream. This is our vision. So our satellite growth strategy is to realize KDDI's vision 2030. And 5G and data-driven and AI, and these are like the sun. And we place these and elements as the center of our strategies. And Orbit One as the business domains and finance and energy and digital transformations associated with telecommunications and supporting our growth. And the second Orbit Two, satellite, mobility and healthcare, and so sports entertainment, Web3. That's the next and growing and the challenging fields. The important thing is that we grow our business based on telecommunications and AI. And first, in telecommunications, we have launched the 5G standalone with 39,000 sub-6 base stations all over Japan. And this 5G SA launch has greatly enhanced our customers' experience. As proof of our efforts, in Open Signal survey last fall, we got number one for network quality in Japan. And now, we have more exciting news. We got this news last week. And in Open Signals and Global Survey, we got the top rank in 3 out of 6 categories and has become number one for our networks and quality in the world. Very good news. So thank you very much. So. And we collaborate with SpaceX for services using satellites. And we have already used SpaceX as our backhaul of base stations. and especially for emergencies and disasters. Last year, when the big earthquake took place, its usefulness was a problem. For the direct-to-service using Starlink satellites, we are launching the service from this spring. With this, we will provide a great connection experience for people. Our goal is, and as long as the sky is visible and we can connect anywhere, that is our goal. And our services using Starlink are not only for consumer services, but the enterprise and customers as well. And this slide shows the construction company are using our service in a tunnel in the mountain. And the first picture on the left-hand side, we set up the area to use Starlink. And the second picture, we gather the real data to use the robot, which are gathering the inside of the tunnel. And the third picture, we gather the data to use a drone outside the tunnel and transfer this and the collect data to a construction design section as a headquarter in real time. It has significantly evolved and compared to before the introductions of this system. And KDDI is one of the founding members of a GSMA Open Gateway. An Open Gateway provided the capability of telecom companies through common APIs and enable our power to connect to our partners. As the light side shows, we recently joined Aduna to deepen relationships with other mobile network operators. We are going to accelerate the development and the services with applications and developers. And digital twin. Digital twin will be the key to achieve our strategy. Analyze and layer data in the virtual world and use it to improve the real world. Today, I would like to talk about what we are doing at Real Shops and Smart City. The first is about retail shops. And last year, we invested in a convenience store chain named Lawson. In addition to our present retail and the contact point from a smartphone, we are managing more than 14,600 convenience stores all over Japan, which has become a very precious and real customer touchpoint. And convenience store in Japan, of course, 24 hours open. And of course, you can buy, for example, ice cream and sweets. Sweets is very popular for Japanese people. And very nice that we will strengthen these touch points with digital technologies. And these are very important footholds, of course, in the urban area and also rural area. We installed signage to show recommendations so that we can upgrade the customers' shopping and experience. We are planning to establish remote contact centers. There, we will provide asset management, medication instructions, and government services, and smartphone-related services also. And of course, we use this kind of the touch point, and we will use AI. And to resolve the labor shortage in our society, we will use robots, and we will digitize work streams, and such as the product and the supply and the store cleaning and delivery. The future and a convenience store and will be a place and where real and advanced and technologies coexist. The second point is for a smart city. The picture at the center is a large scale of new smart city and opening by East Japan Railway Company, named the Takanawa Gateway City. And the Takanawa area is the center of Tokyo, and the area is close to the Tokyo Haneda Airport, and also Japanese bullet trains. And this is a smart city trying every great experience. So we have agreed with the vision and decided to move our headquarters to the area to participate in the experiment. And more than 13,000 people are expected to work there, and including our employees. Now, I'd like to contribute to the development of the smart city and with the data collected from them. And in Takanawa, we developed an urban digital twin platform operation system, a little bit long word, so based on all data collected from the Takanawa area, such as population flow, and information from shops. After then, the real shopping becomes and easier, and the people's working environment is more comfortable, safe, and secure. Of course, in our new headquarters, there is the latest convenience store to use our technology. So maybe a no counter that we can everything only to use a smartphone, and the some robot and take this coffee to my room. That is so convenient. So we are moving ahead for the construction of an AI data center. As you know, securing a large volume of electricity and water cooling is essential. We collaborate with Sharp to convert their factory into an AI data center. We are planning to start a construction from April. We plan to install the latest NVIDIA AI server and GB200 and VL72. And enhancing the power to connect and empowering the people to dream. That is our vision, our purpose, so that is so important. And before I conclude on my presentation, please watch a short video, please. Hola. Welcome to a life transformation, and thank you very much. Then we have a booth at Hall 4, and the same hall with this presentation area. And if you visit, you will see the future of the Japanese convenience store. And I think our booth is very unique, and you can find easy. Please come to our convenience store, but unfortunately, I don't think you will be able to get ice cream and sweets. And if you really want, and please come to Japan. Thank you very much.